change it to the closest, like, 0 or 5.
Well, you're telling me how to round, I'm asking why we round.
To make an estimated guess.
Make an estimated guess, Isabel?
To make everything easier.
Yeah. We round because sometimes close enough is good enough. I kind of like the small thing. In other words, if by some chance, you know, you bought a shirt or something and somebody said, how much did you pay for it? You know, you're probably going to say, I spent $15 for it or $20 for it or whatever, when in fact you might have spent $15.35 or $21.16. But they don't need to know that. Sometimes being in the ballpark is just good enough. And that's when we do sort of rounding things. And yes, Ben said, we're doing some estimating today, so that's one of the reasons we do it. You sometimes round so that you can estimate easier. But to round, the first thing you must understand is, what am I rounding to? So I'll give you an example here. Let's say you are, well, let's do this. Let's round to the nearest. Let's go one time, let's round to the nearest 10. Let's round to the nearest 100. And let's round to the nearest 1,000. Notice I didn't give you a number yet. Let's do that. Let's say I've got the number, well, let's start with an easy one first. Let's just say I have the number 75. Well, let's say 76. If I have the number 76 and I said round to the nearest 10, okay, I know you can give me the answer, but I'm going to kind of give you the gist there. When you're rounding to the nearest 10, okay, the only answers you're allowed to have are numbers that you'd get to if you were counting by 10. In other words, this. I'm going to draw a little number line here. Okay, I'm going to start with 10, 20, 30, and you don't have to do this for everything, but I'm just going to show it to you once. 50, 60, 70, 80. Okay. When I'm talking about numbers in the tens place, I'm talking about 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, 100, 110, 120. Okay, the number 76. Number 76 falls right about here. So when I'm rounding 76 to the nearest tens, my two choices are either, are the numbers that 76 falls between. It can either be 70 for my answer or 80 for my answer. And what tells me, what is the most important number when I'm rounding 76 to the nearest 10? Which number does all the work? Or what digit, I guess I should say, not what number there. Brianna? Yeah, this is the one that you have to look at. The one next to the number you're rounding. I'm rounding the 7. It's either going to stay a 7 or it's going to become an 8. And what tells me that is this number 6. Because that's a 6, if it was 5, it would be exactly halfway between 70 and 80. But it's a 6, that means it's closer to the 80. So when I round it, it has to be the 80. If it was 75, I'm kind of in a dilemma, right? Because 75 is exactly halfway. Well, apparently some guy, hundreds and thousands, well, probably hundreds of years ago, said, we're just going to say, if it ends up being exactly in the middle, we always round up. Okay. They had to make a decision with what to do with the number 5 because it's right in the middle. Well, they said, anytime it's a 5, always round up. If it's 4 or less, you're going to round down. If I would have told you to round to the nearest 10, 74, okay, then it would be closer to the 70 and not the 80, so you'd have to make that 70, not 74. Now, what about rounding 76 to the nearest 100? Interestingly enough, if you think about a number line that has hundreds on it, you have 0, you have 100, you have 200. Where is my arrow for 76 go? Well, halfway between those is 50, 75. 76 falls right about here. So rounded to the nearest 100, 76 would be what? And your choice is either between 0 and 100, those are your two choices. Jillian?
100.
Yeah, it's closer to it, round it to the nearest 100, it's closer to 100. And if I asked you to round 76 to the nearest 1,000, that gets a little goofy, but this is what it would look like. Here is 0, here is 1,000. Where does 76 fall on that line? Where does 76 fall on that one? Allison? Well, here, let me give you, halfway between this is 500. Well, it doesn't fall on 0, but, you know, if you did 100, 200, 300, 400, 500, 76 would fall somewhere close to right there. Rounded, it does give me 0 because it's closer to 0 than it is 1,000, so you get 0 there. Okay. So let's throw another number here. What if I have 3,422? Rounded to the nearest 10, what's going to be my answer? Because I don't want to bore you and all that. Okay, rounded to the nearest 10, before we even answer that question, what are my two choices? If I'm rounding 3,422 to the nearest 10, my two choices are, Kara?
20 and 30.
Well, 3,420 and 3,430. Don't forget the numbers in front, they stick with it. Now, then the answer would be round to the nearest 10, Kara.
3,420.
Right, 3,420 because of this number right there. Because that is 5 or less, or 4 or less, this 2 is going to stay the same. Rounded to the nearest 100. What are my two choices? If I'm rounding 3,422 to the nearest 100, my two choices would be, Luke?
3,400 or 3,500.
Correct. And because it's 3,422, the most important number comes after the 100. It's at 2. That means I'm going to round it to what, Luke?
3,400.
3,400. Because of that, too. And then rounding to the nearest 1,000, what are my two choices? Rounding to the nearest 1,000, Molly?
It would be, I think 3,000.
Or, what are my two choices?
3,000.
No. If you're counting by thousands, you'd go 0, 1,000, 2,000, 3,000, 4,000. So my two choices, if it's 3,422, it's either going to be 3,000 or it's going to be 4,000. Okay, because I can only use thousands, everything else will be 0. This is closer to what, 3,000 or 4,000?
3,000.
Exactly. The nearest 1,000, it is 3,000. Now, just for those of you that catch up, what if I was rounding to the nearest 10,000? Ooh, is it closer? Counting by 10,000, you'd go 0, 10,000, 20,000, 30,000, 4,000. What is 3,422 closest to if you're rounding to the nearest 10,000? Elijah?
Zero.
But they won't ask you to do that. I just thought that would be fun. Wouldn't it be fun? Okay, now, blank piece of paper again.